different party system. Countries around the world have different party system. These are broadly broadly categorized into one party or single party, two party or bi-party, or the multi-party system. So there are three type of party system in the world. First one is the one party, that is a single party. Second is two party, that is the bi-party, that means in that particular country only two parties are present. And the last one is multi-party system, that is just like our country India, we have multi-party system. In some countries only one political party exists. This is called one party system. In such a system, the voters really do not have much choice, as all the candidates belong to one single party. Okay, so what does the one party system means? It is a system in which in a country only one political party is present, and thus the candidates, that means the citizen of that particular country, do not have any choice to choose the which political party is better. One party system is not very desirable, as a single party might become dictatorial. One party system exists in China. So one party system is not good for any country, because only every year same party is participating in an election and they are winning. Okay, that's why it is not desirable. And the example is China. In China, one party system is present. Some countries such as Japan and United States of America have two party, also called bi-party system. So in Japan and United States of America, that is USA, two party systems are present. After election, one party forms the government and the other party forms the opposition. So in this type of party, that is the bi-party, only two parties are present, that is only two political parties are present. Okay, and after an election, one party will win, and that is they will form the government, and the other party who lose, they will form as the opposition party. In a two-party system, the voters have less but clear choice. So in a two-party system, the voter has very less choice that which political party is better. Moreover, as both the parties are aware that they can be replaced easily by each other, they work hard to look after the welfare of the people and win their support. So as there are only two political party in these countries where the bi-party system is practiced, so the political party, they know that they can easily be replaced by each other. That's why they work hard so that they can do the welfare of the people, and hence they can win the support of the people. Next is multi-party system. In countries like India, Pakistan, Canada and Australia, there are many political parties. Voters have a wide choice and they can choose from several candidates belonging to different parties. This is called multi-party system. So what does the term multi-party system means? It is a party in which huge amount of political parties are present, and the candidate or the citizen of that particular country have a varieties of choice so that they can choose the best leader for their country. In such a system, while numerous political party claim to represent the aspiration of different section of the people, the voters are often confused. So as there are huge number of political party present in the country, that's why the candidates, they sometimes they get confused, like to which party they should give their vertical vote and to which not. So this is all about the multi-party system. Sometimes after election, no single party gets a majority to form a government. Two or more parties come together to form a coalition government. So sometimes after an election, there are many political party who do not get the majority form majority votes to form a government. That's why they do an agreement, that is coalition government. Coalition means agreement. They do the agreement with whom? With two or more political parties, so that they can form one political party and they can participate in an election. Next is political parties in India. India has a multi-party system. There are many political parties, some of which have their presence all over India. These are called national parties. So India is a multi-party system, which we have already discussed in the above paragraph. So there are many political parties, and due to which different political parties, they are present all over the India. So this is known as the national party. Some political parties that work only at the state level are called regional party. So those party who only work at the state level, they are known as regional party. And some party who work at the all the area of a country, that is all the area of India, they are known as national parties. द इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस भारतीय जनता पार्टी एंड कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी ऑफ इंडिया आर एग्जाम्पल ऑफ नेशनल पार्टी सो दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ नेशनल पार्टी हुज ऑल द मेंबर्स आर स्प्रेड ऑल ओवर द कंट्री बहुजन समाज पार्टी बीएसपी इन उत्तर प्रदेश झारखंड मुक्ति मोर्चा जेएमएम इन झारखंड एंड असम गण परिषद एजीपी इन असम द एआईए डीएमके एंड डीएमके इन तमिलनाडु द शिवसेना इन महाराष्ट्र द राष्ट्रीय जनता दल आरजेडी एंड लोक जनशक्ति पार्टी एलजेपी इन बिहार एंड द तृणमूल कांग्रेस इन वेस्ट बंगाल आर सम ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट रीजनल पार्टीज इन इंडिया सो दीज आर द सम ऑफ द रीजनल पार्टीज हु वर्क एट द स्टेट लेवल एंड हेंस इट इज नोन एज द रीजनल पार्टीज ऑफ इंडिया In a country like India, regional parties play an important role. Formed on the basis of language, caste and even religion, these parties reflect the aspiration of the diverse group of people living in the country. So, the regional parties who work at the state level, they play an important role because they form the government on the basis of language or caste or even the religion. And these parties hence represent that how our India, despite of many religion who live in our country, they form the government and they try to make different rules and regulations so that the people can stay peacefully in a country. Next is coalition government. We have already studied that after election, when one party does not win majority of seats required to form a government, many different parties come together to form a coalition government. So I have already told you what does the term coalition means. It means agreement. So when, or you can say after an election, if one single party does not get the maximum majority so that that particular political party can form the government, then that party can do an agreement with the other two or more party so that they can form the the one government and they can get the maximum number of votes. So this is all about coalition government. That means to do agreement with two or more political parties so that they can form one political party and hence they can get maximum number of votes. Before a coalition government is formed, all the political all the parties forming the coalition hold a discussion to chalk out a common minimum program. So before they decide that they will form a one political party, they come together, they sit and they discuss about what are the different types of measures they will do, okay, how they will make different types of schemes so that they can do welfare of the people, okay, how they can win the support of the people. So first of all, before deciding that they will form a one party, they first discuss among each other. For the success of a coalition government, it is important that in spite of difference, all the members of a coalition should respect the common minimum program. So in order to make the coalition government successful, it is important that all the members of the different party, they should respect their program, okay, and they should also respect each other. However, in reality, in a coalition government is often caught up in the internal squabbles of its member. This greatly hampers the smooth functioning of the government. So, till now, whatever the coalition government is being formed in India, it does not work properly. Why? Because different members, they have different views, okay? And that's why they keep on conflicting or fighting with each other. That's why the functioning of the coalition government does not work properly as compared to other political party. Coalition government have advantage as well as disadvantage. So coalition government, it has advantage as well as disadvantage. It take care of the welfare of the diverse group of people as the various political parties comprising it represent different section of the society. So the first advantage is that it look after the welfare of the different group of people as the political as the member of different political parties. They are coming together and they are representing the different section of the society. This is one of the advantage. So in a coalition government, public opinion of a large group of people can be voiced strongly. So hence we can say that in a coalition government, different people from different groups, they come and they form the parties and hence they represent the different social group. And hence we can say that huge amount of group, they come together and hence their unity plays an important role in the coalition government. However, coalition governments sometimes become weak and indecisive, as often conflict of interest among the various member parties occur. So now we will talk about the disadvantages of the coalition government. As you already know, different people, they come from different community, different section of the society and different social group, right? So obviously their interest, their opinions does not, you can say, match with other political party. That's why it leads to the fighting among each other. Instead of concentrating on the governance, the ruling party spend more time in appeasing the unhappy member. In such case, governance take a back seat. So instead of concentrating to make different types of schemes and measures so that they can win the election or they can win the support of the people by doing the welfare of the society, rather than they are fighting among each other and they are just criticizing other members, and hence the coalition government, it hardly works. Okay, so this is all about the coalition government, its advantages and disadvantages. And with this, we end the chapter.